What is the difference between a British pool table and an American pool table? Well, it's actually a really good question because both games are quite different. And when you look closely at some of the detail, it will hopefully allow you to make a more informed decision about what type or what style of game might be appropriate for your games room or maybe your commercial premises. Now, the first thing that comes to mind is to look at the size of the tables. This is where there's probably one of the most dramatic differences between the two different types. So with British pool, you're normally going to be playing on a 6 foot up to a 7 foot table. So 7 foot by 4 foot is the full size British table. That's if you're playing in a pool league or something similar. The 6 foot tables are really were designed just if there was tighter queuing room around, but they're also very popular and they tend to fit in a lot of different homes and things like that in the UK. American tables, however, go from an 8 foot up to a full size of 9 foot. So if you've been playing American pool in American pool halls, you're probably, as long as they've got the space as well, been playing on a 9 foot size table. Now, there are some other dramatic differences, and a lot of that comes down to the equipment that is being used on the table. The best way to start to explain how it all changes is to look at the equipment that you get. So here is one of the most dramatic differences. It is the pool ball size. So on a British table, you're looking at a 2-inch pool ball. And on an American table, you're looking at a 2¼-inch. Now that 1/4-inch doesn't sound like a lot, but actually when you look at them together, it makes quite a difference. So these tables are built to have an appropriate pocket size for the pool ball size. Now, this doesn't necessarily make the game any easier just because an American table has a larger pocket, because you're generally shooting over a much longer span on the table. So you need to be quite accurate still on both of these, but it could be argued that the American game is just a little bit faster. You should get more pots, and I think it can be a bit more family friendly. So that's something to consider. British ball is considered a little bit tighter and a little bit harder to master. Right. Now, one other thing to mention is that a British table actually has a 1⅞-inch cue ball. Now, this actually originates because the cue ball needs to be returned through a British table in a pub environment. So again, when you start looking at cue ball differences between an American table and a British table, it gets even more dramatic. Now, luckily, there is equipment to deal with these two things. Now, I won't touch on this for too much detail, but if you have a quick look at a British standard pool cue, this is just a 57-inch full-size cue, you can see the tip of the cue is designed to control that smaller cue ball. And that'll be something like between about a 9 and 11 millimeter tip. Now, when you look at the equipment you'll get with your American pool table, that's got a 13 millimeter tip. And again, you can see that is really an appropriate size to be able to control the cue ball for the 2¼-inch size. So that gives you a little idea of what you might get. Now, in terms of the game, and I won't go into all the differences between the games themselves, but you'll expect to get a triangle with a British pool table, and you'll expect to get a diamond if you're having an American table, but you also will get a triangle generally as well. And again, we'll do a different video looking into the actual intricacies of the two games, but that's what you can expect to get. Now, moving down through the table, I'll try and take you right through the differences in the way they're constructed. So the first thing to consider is the cushions. So on a British table, it uses a flat-nosed cushion. And on an American table, you get more of a wedge of rubber. And that isn't the only difference. It's also the way that the cushions are cut into the pocket. So you'll see on a British table, you'll get the radius of the curve that goes into the middle pockets and into the end pockets are going to be different to you see on an American table. Generally, they are just a straighter, sharper cut. Now, there's no particular advantage to one or the other, but it's just a difference that you're going to be able to see. The next thing as you move down on the table is the cloth. So British tables generally come with a napped cloth. This means that where you rub the cloth one way, you'll find some resistance and then it'll be smooth the other way. And you tend to find on American tables, they use a napless cloth. So there's no particular direction to the nap. Now, British tables, you might have more of a wool content. You might get more of a mix of nylon content when you're looking at American tables. Now, the next thing to look at is what's underneath the cloth. That's the slate. So that's the piece of rock that's making the play surface. Now, a British pool table will generally have a single piece of slate. This is simply because of the size of the table. It means that for the installers of these tables, a single piece slate is manageable enough in that size. With an American table, when you're talking about 8 foot and 9 foot tables with a 1-inch slate, The weight of the slate, if it was kept all as one piece, would just be too much to handle and would be a bit too dangerous. Although there are the odd one-piece American table out there, the general rule of thumb is that you will find that there is a sectional slate table. So this means that the piece of slate has literally been cut into three sections, and then it's more manageable. When they then install an American table, they'll have to put each slate together, and they bring them together and line them up and level them independently until they become a complete sort of uniform flat surface. Now, the consequence of that means that if you're looking for a table that you want to be able to occasionally move around, then a single piece slate table is okay. As long as you've got enough people to lift it safely, you can sort of move it from one place, bring it back, may need to level the feet, and off we go. But if you're looking at an American table, if you try and move that table, you are most likely going to disturb the three pieces of slate. They're going to ruck up, they'll have a ridge. So again, have a think about whether this table is going to be in your room permanently, and that way you can make the right decision. Now, in terms of style, although British tables have caught up these days and are very stylish, there is an argument to say that American tables have got probably the broader range of styles. And a lot of the more dramatic tables you see out there are American tables. So they've always been quite an exciting table to look at. Now, I'm not saying again that the British tables aren't, but you tend to find that they're catering for pubs and things like that. And slowly but surely, they're catching up for the home market. And there's some really cool styles out there as well. So I think that covers the basics of what you should be looking at between the two games. Remember that British pool is maybe a slightly slower game. It relies on a little bit more extra skill level, but an American table is more a faster game, lots of rebounds off the cushions, lots of pots, lots of movement. And, you know, hopefully that area of information just helps to give you a narrowing focus on what table will be appropriate for you. So I hope that helps, and we'll be going into depth on the actual gameplay of the two in a separate video.